Good morning, everyone. It's always a wonderful feeling to be back in school because it brings back a lot of nostalgic memories, and I'm really thrilled to be here in the school today. Respected Father Shaju, respected teachers, dear speakers, and my little friends. So I'm going to begin my topic with a very short story, just to get the context of my topic in place. So this story is about a ship that sailed about 100 years ago in Atlantic Ocean. And the ship gets caught in a severe storm. So everybody starts running for cover, for the safety. Now one passenger who was very tensed and he was running for cover, he noticed that there's a small girl who was playing with her little doll, unperturbed by the happenings. So this gentleman gets a little curious and he walks up to that girl and he says that, little girl, do you know what's happening? So the girl looks up to the man and says that, what is the matter? This person tells her that the ship is caught in a deadly storm and it is about to sink. When the little girl listened to this statement, she looked up to the man and with a very calm face, without an iota of tension, she said, "Sir, the captain of this ship is my father and he will not let it sink." So the belief that little girl had in her father did not allow her to become the victim of fear. Similarly, at a much larger level, when we believe that God is the captain of the ship of our life, then whatever is the situation that we may face, we will be normal and we will not get worried. So this is what faith is. This is what we get from the conviction of God. Now let me explain to you that what is the concept of God in Islam. The God concept in Islam is not an abstract idea. God is not someone sitting high up there who does not have any connection with the creation. In fact, the Islamic concept of God is that God is a living and dynamic God and has a very close relationship with man. So the concept of God in Islam is that of monotheism, that there is one God. There is a verse that says that your God is one God. There is no deity except him. He is the compassionate, the merciful. This is in chapter 2 of Quran. Yet at another chapter, 112, Quran says that say that God is one. He is self-sufficient and none is comparable to him. So according to Islam, the ultimate reality of this universe is one, that is called God in Islam. I just want to add one point, that when you love God or when you believe God, then it inbuilds a psychological absorption system in you. Think about a car. I mean, you all travel in cars. The car has absorbers, shock absorbers. So whenever the car goes through rough patches, through uneven roads, potholes, you don't feel the shocks because it absorbs the shock. So this is what the faith or belief in God does to you. Whenever you pass through a difficult phase in life, you are able to absorb the shock because the conviction that you have in God, and you remain cool and level-headed. Now this is, you know, just one side of the story. There is always the other side. There are people who say that God does not exist because there is no scientific basis. Now I disagree with that. There are of course a lot of studies. Anthropology, which is the study of science of man, has established that the concept of God is interwoven, it is ingrained in our personality. So we are born with the belief in God. Now if that is the case, then why is it that people still doubt the existence of God? The reason is very simple. We always try to seek rational responses to our inner beliefs. And I want to, you know, explain a little bit more, that if you really want to understand the scientific basis, then you'll have to divide the human knowledge into two phases, the pre-Einstein phase and the post-Einstein phase. In the pre-Einstein phase, everything was macro-based. which was observable and measurable. For example, all of you children are sitting here. I am looking at you. So you exist for me. Likewise, you, all of you are seeing me talk. So I exist for you because I am observable. This was a scientific criteria that was applied on God, that you can't see God, therefore God doesn't exist. Now this is not only not scientific, but it is an incorrect criteria. Now what happened in the post-Einstein era was the breaking of the atom. Some of you may be studying it, some of you will study later. So what happened is that when the atom was broken, then even matter in the last resort was nothing but invisible waves. So what argument it gave to rise was that an inferential argument is as valid as a direct argument. Let me explain that to you. If you throw an apple up, you know, it comes down. So when you look at the result of the falling apple, you infer that there is gravitational pull. Similarly, when you look at a photo film, you infer that this is a result of an X-rays from a particular machine. That is why it is called X-rays. So observation alone is not a valid argument. And this changed the argument that if inferential argument is also as valid as a direct based argument. Secondly, in the first half of the 20th century, you all would have heard that the Big Bang theory was propounded. The Big Bang theory said that life began 13 billion years ago, which means that if there was a beginning, then there was a beginner. When you look at the solar system, you look around the environment, you look at how the life support system works, then one is compelled to think that if there is a design, then there is a designer as well. So this is what the scientific criteria is, and it gives conviction that yes, there is some intelligent mind behind, and this intelligent mind is none other than God. So science does not use the word God, but when you use the findings and discoveries, you are able to infer that there is God Almighty. Now, the divinity or the concept of unity in divinity is, it also engenders spiritual unity. The Prophet of Islam would always rise up every morning and he would make this prayer that, O God, I bear witness that all the human beings are part of one family. So it in a way gives rise to a common brotherhood example. There is this verse which explains this in Al-Fatiha chapter, which says, all praise is due to God, the Lord of the universe. So here the verse does not say God of some community. It says God of entire mankind. The oneness of God is the basis of oneness of humanity. And it also, Quran also talks about, you know, global brotherhood. It says in chapter 49, and let me read this out to you. Mankind, we have created you from a male and female and made you into peoples and tribes so that you may know from one another. So basically, God is looking at entire humanity as one. When God himself looks at entire humanity as one, then we should also adopt the same thinking of treating our fellow beings as part of one family. One more thing that Islam emphasizes is the interaction part. For a healthy society, it is very important that we interact, we have a dialogue. And religion, the festivals in religion does this very beautifully. So you know about the festival of Ramzan and Eid. Now what this festival brings out is the spirit of brotherhood. After the fast is over and when the Eid celebrations are done, the Muslims have been enjoined by Prophet of Islam to do Sadqa al-Fitr. Now, what is Sadqa al-Fitr? Sadqa al-Fitr is the charity that you give to the underprivileged so that all the people, the rich or the poor, they all celebrate Eid together. There is a common brotherhood. There is a universal brotherhood. I would like to summarize by saying that what is important is that we first discover God. And when we discover God, we put our faith in God Almighty. Normally, when we part with our friends or relatives, we always say that I'm just a call away. Now, God is even closer to that because God is just a thought away. The moment you remember God, you are instantly connected with Him and His blessings start pouring. So I would say that, you know, God is like a lighthouse. When a sailor of a vessel finds himself isolated or lonely in an ocean and he is trying to reach to the destination, when it sees the lighthouse, he is thrilled because he is able to reach his vessel to the coast. Similarly, we have to think that whenever we are helpless or whenever we need help, we just have to remember God and He will show us the way. He will help us out. So I would just say that, you know, God is just a thought away. And with this, I will end my short, talk. I wish you all the best and may God bless you all. Thank you.